In this video, we're going to take a look at some of the more fun or novel features in Final Cut Pro's retiming menu. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge, and welcome back to my channel for another Final Cut Pro tutorial. Just a quick reminder, if you find these tutorial videos helpful, please hit the subscribe button below. It does mean a lot to me. So, like I mentioned before, in this video, we're going to take a look at some of the more fun retiming features included in Final Cut Pro. If you click the Retime menu button at the bottom of the viewer, as you can see besides the standard slow, fast, and speed ramp options, Final Cut Pro gives you the option of adding an instant replay, rewinding your clip, or performing a jump cut at markers. First, let's take a look at the instant replay option. What you need to do first is isolate the part of your clip you want to see an instant replay on. Select the range tool from the tools drop-down menu, and down in your timeline, click and drag out a part or an entire clip whose contents you want to use to create an instant replay. Next, open the Retime pop-up menu, select Instant Replay, and choose the clip speed from the submenu. Your clip range is duplicated and appended to the selected range, and plays back at the speed you selected from the submenu. A speed ramp is added at the end of your instant replay, which gradually ramps up the speed of your clip back to normal. Also, an instant replay title is added to your clip in the top right corner. This can be adjusted or removed like any other title if you don't like the way it looks. Next, let's take a look at Final Cut Pro's rewind feature. This, much like instant replay, is another way to replay an exciting part of your clip. Once again, select the range tool and click and drag out the range of your clip you want replayed. Next, from the Retime menu, select Rewind, and from the submenu, select the Speed. What this feature does is it appends a duplicate of your clip as a segment, rewinds a duplicated segment at 1, 2, or 4 times the speed, and then plays the original segment again in forward motion at normal speed. To adjust the speed of any of your clip segments, click and drag the selected section's retime handle to the right to slow down or to the left to speed up the clip. And last, let's take a look at Jump Cut at Markers feature. This feature is used to compress time in a long clip without speeding up the clip itself by creating jump cuts to periodically skip over a specific number of frames. For example, I have an about 10 second driving clip down in my timeline. To make this clip shorter without speeding up the footage, first I'll add a few markers to my clip, about a couple seconds apart each. Now, from the Retime menu, I'll select Jump Cut at Markers, and to make this effect dramatic for demo purposes, I'll select 30 frames. So, at every marker, 30 frames will be skipped in my clip, so it can be played back in a fraction of the time. Now, depending on the clip you're using, this may or may not be your best method. I find this effect works best for driving clips, or clips with people walking, which when sped up would look unnatural. Like I mentioned before, these retiming effects may be somewhat of a novelty and may not be your best option for professional projects, but in the right circumstances, may be exactly what your video needs. As always, if you found this video helpful, please let me know by hitting the like button and subscribing to my channel. And if you have any questions about this video or anything Final Cut Pro related, don't hesitate to ask in the comments below. Either me or someone else watching this video will help you out. So, thanks for watching. And I hope to see you back next time.